Well, hello my beauties and welcome to my channel. Today another nude makeup release is Will I Buy It? Going on the wish list, yes or no, indie and drugstore. So if you want to know what piques my interest this week, just have to keep on watching. So guys, I think this is number 11. Of my Will I Buy It, new makeup releases, going on the wish list, and all that goodness. So, I have some interesting finds this week. Not a lot of drugstore, but a little bit more of indie. The makeup that I have today, I did film. It is my first impression with the new Copper Spice Fall Palette by 5050 Makeup. And I don't exactly know when it will be up. I want to upload it this week, but I have to see when exactly. But it is coming. Everything else I used, if I have room in my description box, will be listed down below. For those of you who are new to my channel, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm Dutch and I'm a little bit older. So that's good, I think, at least. Anyway, the concept of this video was not thought of by me. It was thought of by Samantha March. Her playlist with her own Will I Buy It videos is listed down in my description box. And she also was kind enough to create a community playlist where creators such as myself who do these types of videos can add their video to. That one is linked underneath the cards. I think it's there, but I'm not sure. It's underneath the card and also in my description box. What else is in my description box are the shoutouts to my beautiful sisters in the Aging Gorgeously and YouTubers Growth group. We are just a collection of very tiny channels that support each other. All their channels are listed down below. Go check them out. And if you like them, hit their subscribe button. And all that goodness, you know how it works, right? Everything I talk about today will be down in the description box below. And a little bit about this video. In this video, I will give you my opinion on products, my reason for buying something or not, or putting something on the wish list or skipping over it, all that thing, goodness. I do have a maximum price that I talk about. I don't talk about high-end products unless they really, really pique my interest. And that is just because my budget is smaller. That is why I focus mainly on drugstore and on indie brands. Because I live in Europe, shipping from America can be pretty expensive. My first choice to purchase from indie brands is usually European-based indie brands. But that doesn't mean that I will not tell you about American-based brands as well. I do often because I just like that. And it's not that I don't buy from American brands. I do. But it really has to pique my interest because not only do I have to pay a higher shipping price, I also have to make sure that I don't go over my import tax threshold, which is 22 euros. Which is about $20 and $25. It just depends on how the exchange rate is at that moment. Just so you know, I am not saying that you need to buy the product or not. I'm just giving my opinion on it. And yeah, if you see anything of interest on Instagram, tag me in it. My Instagram handle is always on my end screen. It is also down in the description box below. Do I have any more household messages? Yeah, I am kind of playing with when I upload. This time of year is actually quite busy for me. I have been doing 5 videos a week, but I have brought it back to 3. And that is a minimum. So you get a minimum of 3 videos a week from me. If I have more time, I will post more, but those will be more bonus videos. And I'm kind of playing around a little bit with what is the best upload time. Most people upload Monday, Wednesday, Friday. I'm not most people. So I want to upload probably Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday or something like that. Let me know if you have preference. But yeah, I have my Instagram in front of me. I will go to the side a little bit. Am I still in frame? Yes, I am. And if you see smoke there, it's because I have incense on. I like burning that stuff, just so you know. Okay, I can put the pictures up here. And let's just start with the drugstore. I always start with the drugstore. I don't have a lot. But let's start with obsession. If you don't know, obsession is... I always thought it was part of Revolution Beauty, but apparently it is an indie brand. Well, Revolution is also technically an indie brand, although it's a bigger one. But apparently Obsession is not a part of Revolution, but it is sold out of their from their site, if that makes any sense. But what I saw was this. And this is the Bright and Bold Be Crazy About palette from Obsession. It retails for £6, €6.99 or $9 at Shop Revolution Beauty. That's their UK based site, but they do ship internationally. And Boots UK. And I think I'm going to get this palette. I have never tried Obsession. From what I can see, Obsession has at least these are cardboard packaging, which I really like. I actually think that these are magnetic packages because it looks like you can plop out the shades. Am I still in frame? Yes, I am. Almost falling out of the camera. Oh no. And I like the colors. And yeah, for €6.99, euros that is, I think I'm going to try that. There is more that I want to order from Revolution. And if I am, what is shipping for me? €3.95 or was it almost, I don't know. Anyway, I plan to do a bigger order from Revolution and I will pick this one up. Because I think it's pretty, I think it's fun, and I love colors. So yeah. And if I have it, I will do a review looks and I will let you know how it is. I don't know yet. If you have anything from Obsession, let me know how it works out for you. Next up is BH Cosmetics. They are collaborating with Mrs. Bella. I don't know who that is. But it says here, take a walk on the dark side with Mrs. Bella. Our fave European bestie has a new palette for your most glam and gorgeous looks. Bring the drama with intense earth tones like Heat and Blood Moon. Slay the sparkle with Green Smoke and Goddess. Or stay under the radar with warm neutrals like Cloud and Warm Stone. I wanted to mention this. I don't know who Miss Bella is or Mrs. Bella. But yeah. I was actually more interested in the names than the shades themselves. I'm going to pass over this. I have all of these shades. I now have an all neutral palette that I can grab when I need a neutral shade. So I'm going to skip over this. I have not tried BH Cosmetics eyeshadows. I do have a foundation. Oh yeah, I need to test out their foundation as well. I forgot. But I have some brushes that I really like. So yeah, again, I'm going to pass. But if you like BH Cosmetics and you like this form or their formula, go check it out. Apparently you also get a blush and a highlighter. So you have a lot in one palette. Don't know what it will retail for, doesn't say here. If you find it interesting, go check it out. The last thing from, well, which I consider drugstore, is from NYX. It is their new, oh wait. It's from NYXcosmetics.nl. So this is for my Dutchies. The new Sugar Trip 24 Days of Beauty Advent Calendar is now available at Douglas Netherlands. So if you want to get that, Douglas Netherlands has it. I haven't really actually seen what's inside of it. Oh, it retails for €52.90. And you get 24 thingies. So if you like advent calendars and that kind of thing, you know that you can get the NYX one through Douglas and probably from the NYX site as well, if you don't live in the Netherlands. That was all the drugstore that I have. I don't know if I'm going to get the NYX one, by the way. I actually want to know what's in it first. So it goes on my maybe list. But that was drugstore. We are going to go to indie. Let's start with Glistening Beauty. Glistening Beauty is coming out or came out with a few things. I have this one, which is a picture of their loose glitters. And it says here, make sure to use code GLITTERS, all in lowercase letters, 2018 for 25% off your entire purchase. And it's a code from themselves. They are an American-based indie brand. They do ship internationally, I checked. I'm not really into glitters. I have two pressed glitter palettes from Revolution. And I have two glitter shades in my eyeshadow palette from 5050 Makeup. I like them, but I don't use them a lot. So I'm not going to get any pressed glitter anytime soon. It's just not my cup of tea. But they're not expensive for $2 each. But I also saw this one, and I'm actually kind of interested in this one. This is their new Adrian shadow palette. And it says here, pronounced like Adrian, but with a Z. Named after one of their favorite beauties, Adrian Rodriguez. They had the opportunity to collaborate with them. Wow. They also say that they have 25% off your entire purchase, no minimum amount, but I do not see a code or anything. And oh yeah, I asked if they shipped internationally, and they do. And if I am not mistaken, this palette, let me quickly check what it will retail for. Really? Oh my lord. I am on their site now, and this eyeshadow palette retails for $13. Just so you know. They also have four matte liquid lippies for $6 each. They have some lashes. Huh. I like it. I like the colors. It is kind of like a rainbow palette, but with a little twist. I like the fact that you have three blues and the shimmer, or two blue mattes and the shimmery bluish green one. I like the purple, green and yellow combination. Oh, I'm going to check what shipping is for me. This is going on my maybe list on the top. And more of like, maybe I'm not going to buy it if the shipping is too high, if that makes any sense. I like this palette from Glistening Beauty. Next up is Blush Tribe. And they are collabing with Sonia Zarina, makeup artist, and Certify. Certify is actually owned by her sister from Blush Tribe. I have the swatches here. This it says here, this gorgeous palette created by Blush Tribe. Oh, this is from Indie Mood. In collaboration with Sonia Zarina, makeup artist, will be coming soon. You see the swatches here, and from my understanding, Certify will create a matching glitter set. They did that as well with the Hasina 2 palette, and they're also doing that with this one. I think the swatches are pretty. I do want to see the palette first, the completed palette. But it's actually a very, I think it is again a unique palette. Yeah, I think it's, you know, I have two eyeshadows, eyeshadow palettes from Blush Tribe, Hasina 1, Hasina 2. I want the Paulina that they are coming out with. I also want the other one she is coming out with, which is also a collaboration and should be a pre-sale, I think, in November. And this one also looks really nice. So you know what, Blush Tribe? Why don't you just go and take my money? Because it's just... This is going on my maybe list, also high up, because I already know I want two palettes from Blush Tribe anyway. Maybe I can plop them in one sale. If you don't know, Blush Tribe is a UK-based indie brand. That way I only have to pay shipping, and because it's Europe, I don't have to pay import tax, so that is nice. So this is going on my maybe list. If I have any more information, I will let you know. I think this will retail somewhere around £28, because that is also the price of her previous palettes. So yeah, it's a definite maybe. Sugar Sweet Cosmetics is doing a collab as well with Apple of Your Eye, and I'm sorry, I don't know who that is, but they are launching this collection next week Friday. Or is it this Friday? I don't know. I'm sorry. I don't know if it's this Friday or next week. I think next week. You see here, let me see, the shade names are underneath, but for the lippies, the top is the nude shade is called Conservative. The deep red shade is called Bad Gal. And the other red is called Classy. They will be $9 each. And the palette will retail for $25. You will be able to use Apple of Your Eye's coupon code, which is MMARZ15 for 15% off. And it's all capital letters, I think it is. They do ship internationally to UK and Europe, but the shipping is high, she says. I don't know how high the shipping is. I need to check that. But because the palette is $25, and to be honest, I have all those shades. Maybe not the, what is it, next to the yellow between, I don't have that blue, and I don't have the, what is it, the one next to the blue, close to the yellow on this side, I think it is. I don't have that one as well, but that's two shades that I actually don't own. The rest of the shades I kind of do, and it is above my, probably just above the threshold for my import tax. So I'm going to skip over this, but I don't think it is a bad price for this eyeshadow palette. I don't know the formula. So if you have anything from Sugar Sweet Cosmetics, let us know down in the comment section below. But yeah, I do think it is a pretty palette. I'm probably going to pass over it just because of the shipping cost and import tax and all that kind of thing. But I wanted to mention it to you anyway. I also saw Multitude Makeup. They are a UK-based indie brand. And they support PND charities. I don't know what that is. I'm sorry. I have no idea. But they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 eyeshadow palettes. And I think the names are hilarious. Night Out, Wine, Sleep, Coffee and Bathe Alone. Or Bath Alone. They are retailing for £10 each. So that is not too bad. You have three neutrals. You have one with, it looks like a bit of cool tone with a pop of color and some grays. I don't know. I think the picture is a bit woozy. But if I were to get palettes, it's the two colorful ones. But I'm not sure yet. I'm going to check out their site, see what they have, see how high the shipping is. This is something I like. But I don't like well enough yet to go out and order, if that makes sense. I just placed an order at Odin's Eye Cosmetics for their Freya eyeshadow palette. So yeah, because I needed that. Freya told me I needed that. Anyway, so yeah, these are very interesting to me. If you have anything from Multitude Makeup, let me know down in the comment section below. For £10, you know, especially if you live in the UK or anywhere else in Europe, go check them out. I don't know what the international shipping to the US will be for them. But yeah, they're fun. They're fun. Again, they go on my maybe list. Where was I? Here. Oh yeah, let's talk about Juvia's Place. And their Warrior 2 eyeshadow palette. To be honest, when I saw the outside, I was hoping they would put in a shimmer red. I really like the eyeshadow formula from Juvia's Place. This is not the best picture. But yeah, the price, it's up for pre-order now. The price is $20. And I don't know if it will come to, is it Beauty Bay that sells it as well? I think it is. And I have no idea if their UK-based site is up and running yet. This is a better picture. Yes. So yeah, maybe it is the lighting, because on some pictures it looks more red. This picture it looks more orangey, but it's just, it is not what I hoped it would be. I had hoped a very nice deep brown. Well, they have a brown and a black, so yeah. But also a very nice red, and I actually really hoped a true shimmery red, if that makes any sense. So yeah, I'm kind of underwhelmed. And the trouble is, I have a picture here, and when I put it next to, well, the picture I showed you in the beginning, you can see the color difference between those pictures. So I don't know which one is true to color. I don't know if it is an orange in the middle or more of a red. I don't know. I'm underwhelmed, to be honest. What I am going to do, however, is just watch some reviews. I really like the Juvia's Place formula. Still gravitating toward the Zulu palette. And I am probably going to skip over this one. This is an all matte palette. Not that I mind that too much, but I just really want a shimmery red. A true red. Still. Hashtag quest for shimmery red or something like that. But yeah, I'm underwhelmed. I'm going to pass on this unless the reviews really blow me away. But probably I'm just going to skip this one. A new indie brand called Shop Nicolita. And they are coming out with this one. This is the Illusion palette. Let me see. They ship worldwide. Can I see where they are based? I think in the US. Yes, they are, as far as I can see, based in the US. The eyeshadow palette will retail for, or retails for, $25.99. That means that I am probably just over the threshold. And yeah, it does look really pretty. It does look really, really pretty. I'm going to pass. Just because, and that sounds so lame actually, but because it is an American-based indie brand, I am going to pass for now. I really like this palette. I like the colors. You can see some of the swatches. I like that as well. I'm very interested in this palette, to be honest. Although it seems to have a brown row as well. Yeah. Let me know down in the comment section if you are getting this palette, if you have maybe ordered this palette already, and then how you like it, or if you don't like it. I like the swatches. I do want to see a little bit more, so some more swatches. And some of the YouTubers that I watch also love colorful makeup and indie brands, so I'm hoping that some of them will pick this one up so I can see their review on it. So it is a maybe. Yeah, it's going on my maybe list. Let's just keep it at that. Okay, next one are two cute little palettes from Breaking Beauty Cosmetics. Do I know more? No, I don't. She has an Etsy shop, so that is good shipping wise. She is based in San Francisco. And she is actually re-releasing her holiday palettes from last year. And I thought these were just really cute. Letter to Santa and Christmas Village. I don't know what the inside looks like. I actually, maybe I can see it on her Instagram if I scroll all the way back. So I just found the picture of the inside as well. It looks like loose shades and it's pretty. I like the Christmas village with the blues and then mauves. I like that one. I have no idea what it will retail for. Etsy shops are usually pretty good with shipping prices. So this one is definitely going on my maybe list. And yeah, if she is releasing these shades again as well, I don't know that. I only know that she is re-releasing her holiday palette. So maybe it is just the outer palettes. I don't know. I don't know what they will retail for. I'm going to keep my eye on this brand. I'm following them already. If I know more, I will let you know. And yeah, I'm very, very interested in especially the Christmas Village palette. I think those shades are gorgeous. And it is a little bit off of what I have in my collection already, if that makes any sense. So I'm very interested in that. So I like that. Do I have one more? Yes, I have one more. That is from Kalon Cosmetics or Kalon Cosmetics. It's the Akilios Goddess Collection Volume 1. It's available now. I think it's really pretty. Let me see if I can find anything else out. So they are obviously based in the US. And can I see what it will retail for here? Ah, yeah, I was afraid of that. It retails for $38. I'm on their site now and it says this palette is dedicated to the warriors living with autoimmune disease. The theme is inspired by Achilles, a minor Greek goddess who brings healing and companionship to others. The sale of this palette benefits the American Autoimmune Related Disease Association. I think it's really pretty. I think it is. Let me see if I can find out if they ship internationally. Oh, they ship to some countries. So yeah, they also ship to the Netherlands. I do want to see some reviews first. So again, I'm hoping that some of my color lovers that I follow on YouTube will pick this one up. But my lord, this is a very pretty palette. This one is also going on my maybe list because this grabs me enough to risk import tax, if that makes sense. So yeah, let me know how you feel about this palette. And you know, this was the last one, so I'm done. Let me know down in the comment section if you know any of these brands, if you are interested in them, if you have different opinions from me. I would like to know that as well. And yeah, if there are maybe any brands or products that I have forgotten to mention, let me know down in the comment section below. The sources I use from Instagram are also listed down in my description box. I will list the companies I talked about. I will mention the products, and if I can find a link to them, I will give you one. But that is it for my 11th Will I Buy It new makeup releasing going on the wishlist. Well, I had one buy it and a lot of going on the wishlist. So yeah, it's going to be hard on my wallet, I think, this week. But yeah, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't hit the subscribe button already, just do so. You know you want to. And then you get notified when I upload my neutral looks and see if I can do a soft neutral look instead of only, well, not so soft looks. So yeah, while you're clicking buttons then, don't forget to click the bell. I don't know if it's working or not, because YouTube is still doing very, very strange things. So yeah, I'm going to stop talking. I'm going to sign off. I'm going to drink some coffee, edit this video so it can hopefully go up tomorrow. I wish you all a great, great day, and I hope to see you in my next one. Bye, guys.